I'd like to welcome back Dominique Landry from Fit Enough. She is a personal trainer. And today's topic is how to get your kids active right now during social distancing. They tend to be laying around a little more than usual and sports have been canceled. So what can we do as parents to get them out there and to be active? Dominique, welcome back. How's everything going on the home front?
Oh, it's going, Mark. What day is this? 1,247? Yeah, I think... We're surviving best we can.
And, you know, I think one of the things, too, with all parents, after a while, you know, it's a lot of time with our kids. So it's a good idea to get them active, either get them outside, get them moving. It's good for them, and it's good for us as well.
Yes, I agree. So I think one of the things we should always start with, and I'm conscious of this as a parent, is, like, how we're messaging to our kids what we're doing. Because I feel like if they think about it either as a punishment or as a way to, like, undo what they're eating or things like that, we're setting up kind of negative references to exercise that we don't want. So the first thing is messaging things of, you know, how are we getting healthy? How are we making sure we're strong? How are we making sure we're our best selves? And starting there in terms of messaging. And so, like, most parents right now, we're on our kind of, like, virtual teaching, and we are essentially teachers or homeschool teachers. And so I actually built in PE times and breaks throughout the day to kind of break up what we're doing, because especially for my son, it's really hard for him to sit and just, like, bang out work. He's just not built like that. He never has been. And so I literally, as we, like, go through our list of things we do and check off what we're doing today, I build in 2 to 3 kind of PE moments. One that I found was really fun, and because it's Easter just passed, we call it PE eggs. And so every night I write on strips of paper and put them in eggs, and they pull them out, like, you know, 10 or so, and they all have an exercise on it. So it'll be like 10 squats or 5 push-ups or 15 jumping jacks or hopscotch 3 times back and forth as a way to make it fun, make it so that both of my kids who are 4 and 6 can do it, in a way to just also break up the day.
I like the idea of the messaging, if you will. It's not a punishment. And the fact you're kind of disguising it, in your case, with Easter eggs, it's that element of surprise that gets them going. The other really important thing that I love is that you're breaking it up throughout the day, because right now kids actually have even more screen time than they used to have, because all their classes are basically how you and I are talking right now, via Zoom. So that's a great idea. And I don't know what it is, but I feel like they need that throughout the day. They need it.
Have
that release.
Yeah. We all need it. I mean, for us, we're sitting on Zoom calls all day. Like, it drives you crazy. Like, you want to get up, you want to move. And so for the kids, it's the same, because they're used to being in a school where they have other peers, and they're getting out for PE and recess, and they're getting up and down for different activities. And so now with this virtual, you know, training and lessons, they're pretty much sedentary the entire time. There's not that active, even if it was just moving from one section of the room to another to do a different activity. They're not doing that. It's pretty much looking at the screen the whole time. So really thinking about how we're breaking it up, thinking about getting outdoors and indoors. I mean, the great thing about living in Jacksonville is you cannot beat this weather. And so I also use my kids to force myself to work out a lot of times, because I know it's important for them to get outside. And I actually feel bad if I don't get them outside when they can go outside. I usually put them on wheels. So anything that moves, be it a scooter, a bike, whatever it is. And then I jog with them to force myself to run, because I do not like running. So I think also if parents can think of ways that you can incorporate your workout when your kids work out, it just benefits the whole family.
And I think kids pick up on that. When they see you take on healthy habits, they're inquisitive about it and they want to do it as well, almost mirror what you're doing. The other thing is, I feel like you're doing a great job of kind of disguising physical activity, because, like you said, it's not a punishment. We do the same thing. Anything on wheels, whether it's scooters, skates, if it's like electronic thing that's pulling them around, sometimes we'll allow it, but it's not.
Yeah.
But I totally get where you're at. Anything else as far as, like, a playful activity that you kind of encourage them to do that might be something, again, just creative for families out there to try?
Yeah, so I think we do a lot of things. So we do the PE eggs, we do outside play. I think we do competitions a lot, which I know, I think most kids love. We give our daughter a head start on anything that we do because she's the youngest and we want to make it challenging for our son. And the same thing is, like, we beat our sons at a lot of things. So I think one of the fun things we do is like roll the dice, and then you have to do however many, we'll name an exercise, roll the dice, and then you have to do like that amount of push-ups or sit-ups or whatever. Or we'll say, okay, who can do the most push-ups or who can hold the longest planks? Because I think when you make it a competition and you make it where they can win something, be it, you know, this is a way that they can win like extra screen time, although we probably know they don't do that right now, or anything that they're working towards, those are the things. And then I think also, we're doing more scavenger hunts and getting out in nature. So if we're doing like a long walk, we're asking like, what are you, you know, looking for? There's a lot going on now in terms of like butterflies, insects, or whatever else. And so I think if we make it a scavenger hunt, you're getting outdoors, you're walking. They don't know that they're doing it or why they're doing it, but you know that it's because it, you know, they need exercise. They need to be outdoors. They need that sun. And so those are different ways we incorporate things as well.
Absolutely. Well, Dominic, thank you again for all your time and information. A lot of creative ideas to get kids moving. We appreciate it. Now, if people want to learn more about you, how can they do that?
Yeah, they can always catch me on IG at @fit_enough or my Facebook page, Fit Enough with Dominic Landry. Or you can check me out on my website, www.imfitenough.com.
All right. Thank you so much. Stay safe. Hope to see you soon.
Thanks, Mark. Thanks for having me. Bye, guys.
Facts have never been more important than now. They can be the difference between life and death. Rely on the Trust Index, your first line of defense against disinformation. Just look for the seal. It's true means it passed the test, and we can back it up. Not true means it's fake. Don't trust it. And be careful means not entirely right or wrong, but it could be risky. In the battle against disinformation, no fact is off the table. If it seems